We have a very fast space of time. Amen. Let's all rise up. Let's all stand up. Open our Bible to. If you have a problem with you, our message for today is written therein. And I'm inviting you to open our Bible to the book of Deuteronomy. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 26.
Way of every Christian.
I would like to give you a background of the Israelites, why they become captives in Egypt. We know that Israelites become a captive in Egypt because Joseph, when he was when Joseph was in Egypt, he was given a authority, okay, and he's in fact a very instrumental why Egypt became a great nation, okay. But when Pharaoh died, he forgot about Joseph and all the Israelites. They forgot about how Joseph has been very helpful in them to become a great nation. And so those Israelites became slaves in Egypt. They were given a hard labor, okay? And so because God is very merciful to the Israelites, as He promised to Abraham, He sent Moses to let them to deliver these Israelites from Egypt, from the bondage that they have been through for more than 400 years. Okay, that's why when God delivered the Israelites from Egypt, and He led them to a land, a promised land, a Canaan, He gave this land to them as He promised to Abraham. Okay, that's why we have read the passage about the land that, about the land that the Lord given to the Israelites, and how God blessed them with this land. Okay, so this text is a call to worship for Israel. God is instituting the feast of the first fruits when they were settled in the land and began to reap the harvest. I'm looking for my own program. So God is very very kind to the Israelites. Okay, that God delivered them out of Egypt through Moses, and God give them this land of Canaan. He promised this land. Okay, so when they were settled in the land and began to reap the harvest, they were to take the first portion and bring it to the Lord as an offering of thanksgiving and worship. So they were commanded, as part of their worship, they were commanded to bring the first fruit offering. Okay? The first fruit of all the fruit of the harvest. It belonged to the Lord. The Lord required them to bring it to the Lord. Amen. So we can see that in every part of worship, sacrifice is involved. Amen. In every part of worship, sacrifice is involved. So let us continue to talk about the meaning of worship. I want you to see the biblical worship always involves an element of sacrifice. In essence, worship is a gift we give to God. Okay? So worship is a gift we give to God who save us from our wretched and lost condition. So we know that before, when we did not yet trust the Lord Jesus Christ, we are lost. Right? just like the Israelites. They are captive, they are bondage, okay? And when we do not yet trusted the Lord Jesus Christ, we are bondage of sin. Amen? And let me remind you that worship is a distinct method of approaching God. Sorry, my lips is dry.
Not hard.
Kailangan ng ano? Gasolina. Okay, let's continue. So, worship is different from prayer and praise. So, worship is a very different thing from prayer and praise. Although prayer and praise is part of worship, but worship is different. Prayer and praise may contain worship, but by themselves they are something altogether different. Okay, prayer is the obsession of the soul with its needs. Okay, so when we pray, we ask for something. Amen. Okay, prayer says, "Lord, save me." Prayer says, we ask from the Lord. Prayer asks for the things the soul desires. Okay, there is nothing wrong with that. We need to pray for our needs. It is what He commands us and invites us to do. And on the other hand, praise is the obsession of the soul with its blessings. Okay, praise says, "Thank you, Lord, for all that you have given me and what you did to me." So we praise the Lord because of what we receive from the Lord. Amen? Okay? So, but worship, okay, this is the meaning of worship. Worship is the obsession of the soul with God Himself. So it's all about God. It's all about the Lord. Okay? Worship focus is not on itself or its blessings. Worship focus is on God alone. So our focus should be to God alone. Our attention should be to God alone. Let us forget everything during our worship to God. But we should give all our focus, all our attention to God. Amen? When we first come to Jesus Christ for salvation, we do so through prayer. So who among us accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior? Can you raise your hand?
Amen.
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 So we should remember the day when we asked the Lord Jesus Christ to save us. Amen. That is through prayer. Okay? When we first come to Jesus Christ for salvation, we do so through prayer. When He saves our souls, we are thankful and praise Him for all that He has done for us. And as we grow in our faith, as we grow in Jesus, we read His Word, the Bible, and commune with Him in prayer. We come to know Him and appreciate Him even more. So, as we grow in our faith, we grow more in the knowledge about our Lord Jesus Christ. He becomes more precious to us as the days go by. Okay? So, let us proceed to our text. God delivered the Israelites from Egypt and give them the land that He promised to them. So I want to share a few truths that present themselves to us in these verses. So the first point of our message for today is the worshipper's appreciation. The worshipper's appreciation. So when we worship the Lord, we should appreciate what God did to us. Amen?
Amen.
Let us read in verse 5:3. I will read. And thou shalt speak and say before the Lord thy God, a Syrian ready to perish was my father, and he went down into Egypt and sojourned there with a few, and became there a nation, great, mighty, and populous. And the Egyptians evil entreated us, and afflicted us, and laid upon us hard bondage. And when we cried unto the Lord God of our fathers, the Lord heard our voice, and looked on our affliction, and our labor, and our oppression. And the Lord brought us forth out of Egypt with a mighty hand, and with an outstretched arm, and with great terribleness, and with signs, and with wonders. So we should, the worshipper's appreciation, he should appreciate, first of all, his redemption. Amen. He should, first of all, appreciate his redemption. The worshipper is to remember that he has been redeemed by the blood of a lamb. Are you redeemed by the blood of a lamb?
Amen.
In Exodus chapter 12, we are reminded about the story of the Passover. Okay? This is the last plague given to Egypt because of their very hard. They are matigas ang kanilang puso. Ayaw nilang magsisig. Okay? And because of the anger of the Lord, He give them 10 plagues, and the last one is the Passover, where every firstborn male will be killed. Okay? And Israelites has been spared about this plague. Okay? Because because of the blood that has been shed. So when the angel visited, they will be spared. Okay? So it reminds us about the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? That only the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ redeem us in all our sins. This same blessing has been given to every redeemed child of God in Christ Jesus. We were born into the slavery of sin. So we know that before, we cannot help ourselves, but we sin against God. We always love to sin. Amen? Before we don't have this fear of God. Okay? When we are not yet a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ, when we are not yet saved, why is it that we always love to sin? Because that is our very own nature. Because we are a captive of sin. Okay? And it's only by the grace of God that when we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, we are redeemed from the bondage of sin. So when we approach Him in worship, we should always come to Him mindful of all what He did for us when He saved our souls. So we should appreciate God, we should appreciate the Lord that He redeemed us. We should appreciate the Lord for His redemption. Amen?
Amen.
And not only that, we should also appreciate the Lord for His restoration. In verse 1, and it shall be when thou art come in unto the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee for an inheritance, and possesses it, and dwellest therein. So we should also appreciate the Lord for His restoration. The Israelite worshipper is reminded that God brought him out of Egypt and has settled him in the promised land of blessing. Okay? So you see how God loved the Israelites. Okay? That not only that he loved the Lord as as what the Lord has given him in grace. So we need to appreciate the Lord that he restored us. Amen. Especially when some of us backslide from the Lord, we go away from the Lord. Okay? But because God loved us so much, he restored us back in fellowship with him. Amen. When David sinned against God, what was his prayer? Okay? His prayer was, restore to me the joy of my salvation. What if God forsook us when we run away from him and he just pinabayaan niya tayo? What should be our life now? But God, because of his loving mercy, because he is merciful, okay, he restored us back unto his fold so that we enjoy the fellowship of being with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So the worshiper is to look back to where the Lord brought him from, and he's also to look around at what the Lord has given him in grace. We need to remember that God has restored us to a place perfect of fellowship with himself, and that God should cause us to worship and glorify him. Amen? So we need to appreciate the Lord. We need to appreciate how he redeemed us. We need to appreciate the Lord that he restored us. Amen? And we need to appreciate the Lord for his rewards. Okay? For his rewards. What is rewards? That is blessings. Amen? Do you have blessings today?
Amen.
Do you have a blessings as a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Do you have a blessings as a adopted child of God?
Amen.
We have many blessings. We have many blessings. In verse 2, that thou shalt take of the first of all the fruit of the earth which thou shalt bring of the land that the Lord thy God giveth thee. So who gives the land to the Israelites? It is the Lord. They did nothing to possess the land. They just go to the land that was given to them, that was promised to them. Okay? And shall put it in a basket, and shall go unto the place which the Lord thy God shall choose to praise his name there. In verse 9, and he hath brought us unto this place. So God brought the Israelites to the land, to the promised land. Okay? And hath given us this land, even a land that floweth with milk and honey. Wow! Where can you find a land like this? With milk and honey. Okay? So we should appreciate the Lord for his rewards. The Israelites' worshiper has to remember that he has been given a place of peace and prosperity. He has to be grateful for those blessings. Is it the same true of us? Is it true with us? That God has blessed us beyond belief, beyond our imagination. In fact, in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3, tells us that he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. So just to give you some spiritual blessings, being a child of God, okay? Do you believe that we are spiritually, we have many spiritual blessings from the Lord?
Amen.
We have with eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
That is the first blessings that we received when we trusted the Lord Jesus Christ. The salvation, the eternal life. Amen. To our visitors, if you are not yet saved, if you don't yet have everlasting life, I urge you today that accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. And the Bible says that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, he shall be saved. So we have everlasting life. We are adopted unto the family of God. And we have the presence of the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5, the Lord says that He will never leave us nor forsake us. Amen?
Amen.
His provision in Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, what the Bible says. But my God shall supply all your needs according to His
riches.
Amen? In Jeremiah 31, verse 3, the Lord says that He loves us with everlasting love. Amen? His forgiveness. Okay? Whatever sins that we committed against God, however bad that is, that is already forgiven by the Lord. If we ask for His forgiveness. Because God's forgiveness is so wide, okay? As far as from the east is from the west, that is how the forgiveness of the Lord is. So there are many blessings that we as a child of God possess. Amen? It's only a matter of knowing these blessings. Okay? So we should appreciate the Lord for His reward. We should always be reminded, we should always remember the blessings of the Lord that has given to us. We should ever meditate on His grace, His love, His redemption, and all His many blessings. As we do, the heart will be moved to glorify and worship Almighty God. Amen?
Amen.
So if we always remember the blessings of the Lord, that will move us to worship God. Amen? So the worshipper's appreciation he should worship the Lord by appreciating His redemption, His restoration, and for His rewards, or all the blessings that he received from the Lord. And number two, what should be the worshipper's approach? Approach or attitude. Amen? The worshipper's approach. In verse 2, that thou shalt take of the first fruit, the first of all the fruit of the earth, which thou shalt bring of the land that the Lord thy God giveth thee, and shall put it in a basket, shall go unto the place which the Lord thy God shall use to place His name there. So, the worshipper's because we come from the same region. The region of where tongue is twisted. So, our approach should be we must come with gratitude. Amen? We must come with gratitude. Gratitude means being thankful. Amen?
Amen.
Okay? They were to take the first of all the food, put it into a basket, and go unto the place of worship. The best of the land. Okay? So we should all develop a heart full of gratitude for all that He has done for us. Okay? So our attitude or our approach to God in worshiping the Lord should be we should be thankful. Amen? We should have a grateful heart. We should all develop a heart full of gratitude for all that He has done for us. Come into His house thankful for salvation. Okay, not only salvation, but mainly spiritual blessings. And I just mentioned it earlier. Okay? So, it reminds me about the 10 lepers. Do you know the story about the 10 lepers? Okay? Let us read in Luke chapter 17, the story about 10 lepers. Luke chapter 17, verse 1 to 11. Verse 1, I will read the story about the 10 lepers. Then said he unto the disciples, it is impossible, but the offenses will come. But 17:11. Verse 11. And it came to pass as he went to Jerusalem, and he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee, and as he entered unto a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, Go, show yourselves unto the priests. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, and with a loud voice glorified God. So there is only one from the ten. There's only one that after he was healed, go back to the Lord Jesus Christ and glorified God. And fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. Okay? And what the Lord said. And Jesus answering said, Were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? Okay? So, we see from the story that these 10 lepers were all healed by the Lord, but only one have a gratitude, have a grateful heart, have a thankful heart that he returned the Lord Jesus Christ. He thanked the Lord Jesus Christ what the Lord has done to him. That should also be our attitude. Amen. We must not forget that God has been very merciful to us. That before we are lost, before we deserve hell, but because of God, God's love, because God loved us so much, He saved us, He gave us eternal life, all by the mercy of God. Amen. So we must approach the Lord with gratitude, with a grateful heart. And not only that, we must approach the Lord with gratitude, but we must approach the Lord with obedience. Okay? We must come with obedience. In verse 2 again, they were told how to come, what to bring, and where to go. Okay? So there is an instruction. There is an instruction given to them. Not only what they want to do, but there is instruction to follow. They were told how to come, what to bring, and where to go. Amen? So, there should be an obedience in our worship to the Lord. In our approach, how we should approach the Lord, there should be an obedience. Only those who follow God's plan were truly worshiping God. Worship always flows out of an obedient heart. If we are going to give Him worship, we must first learn, first of all, to obey His commands. Amen?
Amen.
Do you love the Lord?
Amen.
And what is His commandment? What and how the Lord paano malalaman ng Diyos na talagang mahal natin siya?
Keep my commandments.
In John 14:15, what the Lord said, If you love me, keep my commandments. So that is, it's not only saying the Lord that we love the Lord. It is by obeying His command. It is by obeying His commandment. Amen? So that is how we should show our love for the Lord. If we are going to worship the Lord, our lives must line up with His word and with His will. Only when we are in a place of obedience, are we truly in place where we can worship. So obedience is a very important part of worshiping the Lord. Okay? It is part of our biblical sacrifice of worship to the Lord. So we must approach the Lord with gratitude, with a grateful heart. We must approach the Lord with obedience, obeying what He commands. And letter C, we must come with humility. Amen? We must come with humility. In verse 5, and thou shalt speak and say before the Lord thy God, a Syrian leading to perish was my father, and he went down into Egypt, and sojourned there with a few, and became there a nation, great, mighty, and populous. And the Egyptian evil entreated us, and afflicted us, and laid upon us hard bondage. And when we cried unto the Lord God of our fathers, the Lord heard our voice. So, the worshiper is reminded that he did not do anything of all the blessings that he received from the Lord. Amen? It is all come from God. It is all come from the Lord. So, that should make him humble before the Lord. Amen?
Amen?
We must come with humility. They were commanded to recall his humble beginnings. He was to remember what he was when the Lord found him. Just think of where we come from before, when we are not yet here. Before we, what is our life in our own country? I believe that our life become better now that we are here.
Amen.
Amen. I believe that our life improved when God brought us here. Amen. Because in fact, it's better to go home. It's better to go back to our homeland. But God blessed us so much that He brought us here. Okay. Because there are many people that want to go here. Okay? How many applicants are lined up just to have a job here? Okay? So we are very blessed. We are blessed by the Lord. Amen? So just like the Israelites. Okay? They were commanded to recall his humble beginnings. He was to remember that what he was when the Lord found him. Where we are before. He was to remember that everything he was, everything he had, and everything he ever hoped to be was all the pure gift of the grace of God. We must remember that God hates pride. So, let us remember that what we are is only by the grace of God.
Amen.
Sometimes we fail to remember that what we achieve in life is only from God. Sometimes we take the credit. We are telling ourselves that we are good, or we are intelligent. Okay? We are better than others, that's why we achieve what we are today. But we fail to recognize that it's only by the grace of God. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So, we must remember that God hates pride. Wherever it is found, it reminds me about this story in Luke chapter 18. Verse 11 to 12. This story is about a Pharisee and a publican. Amen?
Amen.
And it is a very familiar story. Okay? Where the Pharisee He's bragging himself that he is better than the publican. Okay? Let me read Luke 18, verse 11 to 12. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank thee that I am not as other men are, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this publican. I fast twice in the week. I give tithes of all that I possess. So he's bragging up about himself. Okay? But we know the enemy story tells us that the publican received the favor of the Lord because of his humility. That should also be our attitude. We should always humble before God. We should always humble ourselves before the Lord. That we, status we are now, what status in life we are now, or whatever achievement that we have, it's only by the grace of God. It's only by the love of God to us. Amen?
Amen?
So that should be our attitude. That should be our approach as a worshiper of God, that we must come with gratitude, we must come with obedience, and we must come with humility. Humility is, it is the most important, because without humility, you cannot have a thankful heart. You cannot have, you cannot obey the Lord without being humble before God. Okay? So, just as a recall of what we've learned, we know that the sacrifice of biblical worship requires appreciation, okay? Appreciation of our redemption, our salvation, appreciation of our restoration, aspiration of all of the rewards or all the blessings, and the worshiper's approach should be should come to God with gratitude. He should come to God with obedience, and he should come to God with humility. And number three, the worshiper's adoration, the last part of our message. And in fact, this is almost the summary of what we learned today. The worshiper's adoration. Adoration for what God has done. When the worshiper came before God, he was to set it before the Lord thy God and worship before the Lord thy God. When the worshiper came before the Lord with his gift from his field, he was giving the Lord back what the Lord had already given him. So he's just giving back what the Lord has already given to them. Okay? Everything he gave had its origin with the Lord. The fact that he gave, it was a symbol of his love for God and for all that God had done in his life. So we can only give back what the Lord has given to us. Okay? What the Lord has done to us. Amen? That should make us adore the Lord. That should make us honor the Lord with all the blessings that we receive from the Lord. With all the things that God has done to us. Amen? And letter B, we should adore the Lord for what God is doing. Okay? We should adore the Lord for what God is doing. God has given them grace to offer something to God. They were able to give because God gave them the ability to give. So it's only all by the grace of God that they have given the ability to give. We see everything is provided the Lord. There is nothing that they can do by their own. It's also a reminder to us that everything we give to God, because God has given these things to us. Amen.
Amen.
Adoration for what God is doing. David expressed this thought in 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 14. But who am I and what is my people that we should be able to offer so willingly after this Lord. So our worship is the same way. We should thank Him for giving us the grace to give back to Him. We should adore Him for what He continues to do in our lives. The Lord is giving us blessings, amen? In our everyday life, everyday lives. The Lord is protecting us, amen? With all the tragedies that is happening around the world, the Lord spared us that is what the Lord is doing to us. Just imagine the tragedies that is happening around the world. What if we are one of the victims in the earthquakes that happened in Nepal? What if we are one of the victims in the fire that happened in Philippines, in Venezuela? What if we are one of the victims of the car accident? But God, because of His loving mercy, God is doing us. That is what is God doing to us. So that should make us adore the Lord. That should make us worship the Lord. That should make us honor the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
And not only that, in letter C, adoration for what God will be doing. The Lord will not stop giving us favor, but He will continue doing, He will continue give us blessings in the future. Amen?
Amen.
Adoration for what God will be doing. We take what He has given us and we offer it back to Him, believing that He will do what He promised He will do. As we worship Him for who He is and for all that He has done for us, we need to remember that the Lord has greater plans and blessings ahead. Amen?
Amen.
So the Lord has been very good to us. Amen?
Amen.
His favor, His blessings has no end. He has been good to us and He is doing us He is protecting us every day, and the Lord will give us more blessings in the future. Amen?
Amen.
What the Lord has promised us as a believer in Christ, He promised us that He will take us away from this sinful world. Amen? In John chapter 14 verse 1, what the Lord promised us. Can we read in John chapter 14 verse 1? And we will be ending soon. John chapter 14 verse 1, this is a promise of the Lord Jesus Christ. In verse 1, the Lord Jesus Christ says, "Let not your heart be troubled." Is your heart troubled of what is happening around us? With all the tragedies, with all the chaos that is happening around the world. But the Lord says that, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in Me. In My Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you." This is the promise of the Lord. "I go to prepare a place for you." So the Lord is preparing a place for us now. Amen?
Amen.
And not only that, in verse 3, the Lord said, "And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again." You see that? The Lord is coming again. Amen?
Amen.
So don't be discouraged of all the hardship that we are experiencing in life. But this should be our hope. We should be encouraged and motivated that we continue to worship the Lord, because of all the blessings that the Lord has promised to us. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, what? There ye may be also. That is the promise of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every believer, everyone that accepted the Lord Jesus Christ can cling to this promise. Amen?
Amen.
So, our adoration for what God will be doing. As we worship Him for who He is and for all that He has done for us, we need to remember that the Lord has greater plans and blessings ahead. He will continue to protect us. He will continue to prosper us. He will come again for us and take us home and live with Him for all eternity. Amen?
Amen.
Are this message enough to move you to worship the Lord? Sacrificially. Amen? How long has it been since you humbled yourself before Him with a grateful heart? We need to be reminded that we should always humble before the Lord. That everything, every blessings that we are enjoying right now is only by the grace of God. It's only by the love of God to us. So we should have a grateful heart and thank Him in pure worship. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, once again, we thank you, Lord, for all the blessings